We did it. Every bit of evidence can be traced to this squad.
Who else would have the unmitigated style to do it?
We got a 24-hour watch on him, unless he doesn't want us to. In which case, he simply goes to Bloomingdale's and he gives us the slip just like that.
You stay with the tall guy. Leibowitz, you take the girl. I'm on a fat man with a fur hat. We got three of them.
This time he's given me a leg up. Now, I don't know why he has, but I know I'm going to nail him.
Chocolates, what do you
think? No, it's no, we're not giving up.
Yeah, but I saw a letter bomb once look like that. You didn't come with a note on it.
We better not rattle it.
Hold it down, please. Yes, ma'am, I'm here. Yeah, it's what? Missing I'm sorry, on the
maybe it's from some guy that Cagney shot down. What do you think?
More than likely.
Yes, ma'am, I have the serial number right here on my desk. I'll let you know. Yeah.
Hi, guys.
How you
What's
doing?
Going on?
Okay, yeah.
Whoa.
Thank you. You got a present delivered by messenger. The bomb squad here is trying to decide if it's safe for you to open it.
Oh, thank you, guys.
Hey, think nothing of it.
Thank you, guys.
Too much.
Thank you, guys. Who's it from?
It says until tonight.
No signature?
I think it's from Steve.
Who's Steve?
Steve Hollister, an investment banker I met while skiing. We're having dinner tonight.
Oh, that was certainly nice of him.
Mm, yeah, it's sweet. Oh my God!
What? Let me see.
Look at this.
Are they real?
Sure looks real to me. Oh, this is ridiculous.
Well, what's the matter? Is that your right size?
Mary Beth, I can't take this.
I agree with you. Hold out for the yacht.
Mary Beth, I have not even been out with this man.
Cagney, Lacey.
Morning, sir.
Morning. You two guys are up next. Jewelry shop, Fairbanks Tower, was hit last night.
Fairbanks Tower is that spiky place on Park, right?
That's it. So move.
Yes, sir.
So, Steve Hollister, is he that rich?
I didn't think so. It's hard to tell in ski clothes.
We had a beautiful gold and emerald piece in here. Went for about 6,000 plus tax.
Fingerprints,
I know,
Mr. Myers.
Sorry. I keep forgetting. You see, what I can't understand is how they got past the sensors and things.
Well, Mr. Myers, where do you keep your sensors and things?
They're over here. Would you like to see them?
Why don't we follow you?
Sure. Would you? Oh, sorry. This way.
Sure.
Everything checked out fine this morning. But no pictures on the video monitors, no alarm set off, nothing.
What about the time locks?
Open, but I don't see how. I mean, obviously somebody made them think it was time to open, but now there wasn't a acetylene torch, but it wasn't even used to open the display cases.
This is very impressive equipment, Mr. Myers. And you're the only one that knows how to operate it.
Me? Oh, goodness gracious, no. I don't know the first thing about it.
Well, who does?
Well, the management company takes care of the actual nuts and bolts. I just flip the switches.
Okay. Well, we're going to want to do an inventory here.
I've been in retail all my life. I could help you with the inventory.
Appreciate the offer, sir, but give us a little time and you relax. We'll let you know.
Let me know if you need any help.
Don't touch anything.
How could somebody so smart, someone who could dance through this state-of-the-art security hardware without a peep, leave a crime scene like this?
You noticed that, huh?
Honest to God, I've never in my career seen such assortment of physical evidence. The DA ought to cite him for littering.
Well, torch may be traceable. We have what appears to be a perfect thumbprint for forensics to play with.
Good. Here's a tie tack that was found on the floor near the vault. And a piece of paper with a number written on it, just crumpled up in the corner. Myers doesn't recognize it.
What's your feeling on Myers?
You mean an inside job? I doubt it. I think the poor man has trouble tying his shoes.
Yeah. So we're about done here, yes?
Yeah. That's it.
How's it going? Is Becky on vacation? Quiet. 5 days along with Bonbon in the Bahamas on vacation. Bet she comes back losing 5 pounds.
He took a large bottle of vitamin E with him.
Wonder if that's enough.
No, ma'am. Not yet. What do you remember? Use fresh the name Rosebud on the back of the toaster oven. Yes, I saw the picture. Well, thank you for your clue, Mrs. Valenti. I'll call back just as soon as I have something, yes. Bye now.
Why didn't you just ask the woman to stop bugging about that damn toaster oven?
Well, we kind of got friendly. She didn't know how to make anything except on her toaster oven, so I gave her a couple recipes.
Such a tough cop.
Your attention! I have an announcement to make. I am pleased to report that the Fairbanks Tower caper is solved.
Solved? Who did it?
We did.
I beg your pardon, sir.
We knocked over the Fairbanks Tower. We did. The whole 14 squad, the entire 14 squad. We did it! According to the forensic report just delivered to me right now, we did it. Every bit of evidence can be traced to this squad. For example, the acetylene torch traced by purchase order delivered to one M.B. Lacey. And the number on the wadded up piece of paper turns out to be a payroll number of the NYPD belonging to Ronald Coleman. And the desk guard at the Fairbanks Tower has one signature in his sign-in book that he cannot account for, and the name is Marcus Petrie. And the thumbprint. Well, they ran that through the R&I computer. Yeah. And guess what? It didn't turn up a known felon. It turned up Victor is Becky, detective third grade of the 14th squad.
This Becky had an alibi. He's on vacation.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, what? Oh, no. Well, you got nothing to worry about. You're the only one that's not implicated.
Is that the hot sheet on the inventory, Lieutenant?
Yes.
How could I see it, please?
So what about the tie tack?
It's mine. And it was given to me by the commissioner himself at my 10-year party.
I was there.
I have something.
What?
It was a present.
Where'd you get that?
Came by messenger.
I don't know.
Sir?
What?
There has to be some kind of an explanation, sir.
Yes, there's an explanation. Somebody is out there trying to make us look like a bunch of monkeys.
Albert Grand.
What?
That's who it is. It's Albert Grand. Who else would have thought this whole thing up and pulled it off?
Albert Grand?
It's gotta be. Who else would have the unmitigated style to do it?
I'll go find out. Go find out, all of you, now!
He's back.
Yeah, I'll hold. Who's got the file?
Right here.
While you're on hold, this was in my desk.
Great, my appointment book. I've been looking all over for... Wait a minute,
Petrie, where did you... That's a follow-up on the aliases.
Petrie, how did you... What? I'm sorry, what? Yeah, okay. Go. On the 23rd? All right, thank you.
So?
Interpol has a positive sighting of Albert Grand in Egypt.
Well, that rules him out.
When was the sighting? Maybe it's old information.
He's suspected of being behind a burglary of the Metropole Hotel in Cairo last night.
Well, it just proves he's still active.
I don't believe it. Albert Grand is the only man in the world who can be in two places at the same time, and I'll lay you 10 to 1 it's him.
20 to 1, you got yourself a bet.
I say, guys, be cool, and I come back fresh tomorrow. I gotta get out of here. Have a nice time tonight, Christine.
Yeah, thanks. Wait till I tell Stephen Hollister what a big spender I thought he was.
I mean, the thing about Albert Grand is he's the absolute last of the great ones. He's world class. I can't help it. I have a feeling in my gut I know he's here.
I can see that.
Can you imagine the audacity of this man? To implicate the detectives who were going to catch the case?
Christine.
Yes?
Look, this is our first date, right? Yeah. When I was thinking about how this evening was going to turn out, I was imagining talking to each other about our families, where we went to school, what kind of movies we like, you know, the sort of things to get to know one another. It's not that I'm not interested in police work, I am. It's just that you do talk about other things too, right?
Yes. I'm sorry, Stephen. I do tend to get a bit compulsive, but I promise you, as of this very moment, I'm officially off duty.
Great.
Somebody.
Christine, my dear. How splendid to see you again.
Hello, Mr. Grant.
Albert, please.
What's going on?
Oh, may I pour you a glass of champagne?
I didn't come here to have a glass of champagne.
Oh, dear. But you're not on duty, are you?
How did you know I was going to be here? My appointment book. You grabbed it when you were setting up the Fairbanks Towers job.
Won't you sit down? Just for a moment, please. I think you'll find this vintage rather amusing.
Thank you. You are under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Should you give up the right to remain silent?
Silence is fundamentally boring. Wouldn't you agree?
Did you hear what I said?
Perfectly, my dear. I still can hear quite well. But I must confess, I'm a bit confused. Whatever would you arrest me for?
The Dunhill Hotel job for openers. I came this close to getting you. And you said so yourself. So, I'm going to take you in for it now.
Really? Does that mean you've uncovered some new evidence in the case?
All right. I'm going to take you in for questioning regarding the Fairbanks Towers job last night.
Well, the evidence in that case would seem to lead in other directions, wouldn't you say?
How would you know that if you weren't involved?
Christine, you wouldn't put a man my age through such an inconvenience without something more specific than, shall we say, a grudge.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to take you downtown just the same. You may have handcuffs or not.
Perhaps I missed something. What was the specific charge again?
There's some people who'd like to see you about Cairo.
Very good, my dear. First class.
Thank you. thank you. Shall we?
Cagney!
Lieutenant, what are you doing here?
Always a pleasure, Albert. I was summoned here.
Did she say the arrest words?
She started to, but we dispensed with the formalities.
Mr. Cagney, this is Mitchell Farnsworth, Mr. Grand's attorney.
How does the attorney get here? He hasn't even made a phone call yet.
Detective?
Steve Hollister, another person in the room.
He's my date.
Here, Albert, sign this.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Lieutenant?
Now, if there's nothing further, Lieutenant...
No, you're free to go, Mr. Grant.
Wait a second. Wait one second. I have something further. I have some questions that I'd like to ask.
No, I'm afraid you haven't.
Well, I'm afraid I have. Because there is a current Interpol APB out on this man.
Cagney.
This is Mr. Grand's passport. The Customs and Immigration stamp clarifies that he entered this country the day before the unpleasantness at the Metropole in Cairo.
I'm so sorry for causing such a fuss. Might I make it up to you? And take you out for that glass of champagne? And your friend, too, naturally.
No, thank you.
Another time, thank you.
Certainly. In that case, au revoir. Goodbye, Lieutenant.
Hey, Hollister. Leave us alone a second, will you? Cagney?
Hmm?
I want this guy. I am putting the whole squad on it. He is not going to make us look like a bunch of monkeys. He is on our turf, and this time he is not walking out of here with full pockets. Do you hear me?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Yeah, so what are you standing around here for? Follow him.
Yes.
Interesting date so far. Where are we going now?
Oh, Stephen, I'm so sorry. I've got to follow him. Do you mind terribly grabbing a cab?
Oh, come on. Let me go with you. This is going to be fun.
But you can't go with me on a tail.
It just occurred to me, my dear, that you might want to follow me. Seeing that the hour is so late, I thought I'd save you a lot of bother. I'm at the Fairbanks Tower, Suite 34A. And good night again.
That guy's some piece of work.
I hope you enjoy the wine, and please keep the pin. It's perfectly all right. The statute of limitations ran out years ago.
Here's another one of them.
Now an associate.
He was part of the Saucon Valley job, a driver.
I'll add him to the list.
We disturbing you?
I'm rereading his book.
You think you're going to trip him up by reading his book?
Well, legwork isn't going to catch Albert Grand. We did that last time, remember?
Oh, by the way, I've run down five of the fences he's used in the past.
Tell me good news.
3 in jail, 1 in Switzerland, and 1's become a born-again Christian.
Maybe you should try prayer.
Excuse me, everyone. Miss La Chocolate here is looking for Detective Is Becky.
Is there something the matter, Miss La Chocolate?
Well, I've been trying to reach Victor since Monday, and his phone doesn't answer, and he's not in his apartment.
Oh.
Well, I'm awfully worried. Did something happen to him?
Victor? To Victor?
Yeah, was he wounded in action? I mean, if there's something that I should know,
Mr. Chocolat, please sit down. As far as we know, Victor is...
Undercover. He's working undercover. Yeah.
You mean he's okay?
It's a very sensitive operation. We don't even know where he is. It's top secret.
Oh. Thank God. I'm sorry, I just... Victor being a cop and all, you get worried.
Of course. As soon as he's finished with his assignment, I'm sure Victor will be in touch.
Thank you.
Take it slow.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Why you lie to that woman like that?
What are partners for?
Kill him.
Why is this Becky telling everybody he's going to the Bahamas with Bon Bon?
I have no idea, Christine. What'd you do with that brooch that Albert Grand gave you?
Part of the loot from the Monte Carlo casino job in 55. It's being returned to the estate.
Why doesn't he just buy you something?
Because he's Albert Grant.
We got another jewelry job.
Where, sir?
Offices of the Van der Voorhis Company.
South African diamond mines.
Yeah, I just hope that we didn't do this one, too.
Can you arrange to keep this out of the newspapers? It's most important to the two officers outside were not helpful.
Another thing that might be helpful is if we figure out who did it. Am I right, sir?
Yes, of course.
They really kind of messed up your place, didn't they, Mr. Irwin?
There's very little value left out here. List. Here's a list of the missing items. Fortunately, the only good piece in the office was in my private safe.
We'd like to take a look at that safe if you don't mind. Even if you do mind, I'd like to.
You see, that tiara is worth about $350,000 American. I only had it out to show a buyer.
Security telephone, right?
Yes.
It's a handy place for it. So as far as you could tell this morning, this safe had not been tampered with.
That is correct.
And all of the damage and trashing was outside?
Yes.
What time do you arrive to work this
morning? Mary Beth.
What?
Diamonds Are Forever by Ian Fleming. New York Public Library, main branch. Does this belong to you?
Certainly not. I don't know where that came from.
Albert Grand left.
Cameras didn't record. No alarms were tripped. Sensors under the carpets didn't register.
Peculiar, sir. All that was taken was a couple $100 worth of display merchandise.
Well, why take all that trouble and then not take the diamond tiara?
Cagney thinks it's a calling card. Like the book, which she's running down now.
Well, how many calling cards does he think we need? We know he's here already.
I don't know, sir.
The library card is no help. The address is a post office box number under the name of Arsène Lupin.
That's Albert Grand, all right.
But I missed something here, what?
Arsène Lupin, gentleman burglar, super sleuth, creation of the French writer Maurice Leblanc.
Must be this man's type of humor.
All right, so where's the list of his movements?
Under your right hand, sir.
All right, so we know he is staying in a luxury suite at the Fairbanks Tower. Got a haircut and a manicure, then he went to Tiffany's. Sorry, forget it. He was only there 5 minutes. Then he went to a doctor's office on Park.
What kind of doctor?
I looked him up. General internal medicine.
But did you talk to him?
I tried to, sir. He cited doctor-patient confidentiality. We'd have to have a court order, if we could ever get one. But maybe it was just a regular checkup. You know, the man is over 70 years old.
Yeah, okay. But then, he goes to Bloomingdale's.
Uh-oh.
That's right, uh-oh. Because that is where we apparently lost him. Until he returns to Fairbanks Towers in a horse-drawn Hansen cab, no less.
In that time, he could have been anywhere, seen anybody.
You want to know what I think?
Yes, sir.
I am sick and tired of being one step behind this guy. We got a 24-hour watch on him, unless he doesn't want us to, in which case he simply goes to Bloomingdale's and he gives us the slip just like that, huh? This guy is laughing at us. I think I'm gonna call Nelman and ask for more men.
No. It wouldn't be of any help.
No, so go on out there and find something that does help.
Yes, sir.
My dear Christine, I'm so glad you could come.
Well, it was so kind of you to invite me, and so very clever. 2000 hours, 8 strokes on the clock, due date.
I knew you could put it together. You're a very talented lady, my girl. Champagne?
Of course, thank you. Hello. I'm afraid I didn't dress for the occasion.
Oh, it's very smart. I like your colors. Would you like them to play something else?
Oh, not at all. It's lovely.
It's Beethoven. Razumovsky. Opus 59, number 1. The Adagio. I must confess, I'm a bit disappointed. I heard from a friend of mine that you'd sent the pin back to France. I hope it wasn't because you didn't like it.
Oh, not at all. On the contrary. It's just a little idiosyncrasy of mine. I had to return it because it was stolen.
Such a long time ago. And the insurance company paid up promptly. So you see, it's the way of the world. Nobody got hurt a bit.
Except, of course, for the insurance company.
But, my dear, that's what they're there for.
You know, you think I see you as some modern-day Robin Hood. The problem is that Robin Hood stole from the rich and gave to the poor. You, on the other hand, steal from everybody and you keep everything.
I do not steal from everybody. I have certain standards.
That was you in Cairo, wasn't it?
Christine, you're so good at this police business. The best I've ever come across. I think if you had chosen my way of life,
You would have done rather well, wouldn't you?
Why are you doing this? I mean, if you're up to something, which you obviously are, why do you alert us like this? Why don't you just strike and disappear without a trace?
I suppose it's not unlike the concept of knight's odds in chess.
I'm afraid I'm not a chess player.
But you are, my dear, but you are. You're one of the best ones I've ever played with.
Oh. I brought this back. You might want to return it. You certainly wouldn't want an overdue library book on your record.
Arsène Lupin.
I brought your book, too. Ah. I thought maybe you'd sign it for me.
I'd be delighted to.
I enjoyed it very much.
It's a little outdated. Although, chapter 11 holds up rather well, I believe.
Thank you for the inscription. And you're under arrest.
Oh, dear. I agree the writing is atrocious, but I didn't think it was criminal.
I'm placing you under arrest for breaking and entering. These are hardly business hours for the public library. You rented the public library?
I've only rented this one room.
I've never heard of anything like that before.
A mere trifle. Easily arranged. Now, Christine, I want to give you something. I mean, something you felt you could keep.
Albert, why don't you just buy me something?
What a quaint idea.
Morning, Sergeant.
Morning, Lacey. Someone waiting to see you in the interview room.
It's not Mrs. Valenti about her toaster oven, is it?
It's worse.
Thanks.
He's not undercover, is he? Oh. Victor always says that you're the straight shooter in the precinct. I mean, you would never lie. They made up that story, didn't they?
Mr. Chocolat, I don't know where Victor is, but I'm sure there's a good reason that he didn't tell you.
Well, it's someone he works with.
Huh?
It's the blonde, right?
Believe me, Mr. Chocolat, there is nothing between Victor as Becky and my partner.
I hate him.
Sure, you do.
Big, dumb, Polish cop.
Sure he is.
Ronald!
Don't get cute, Cagney. What do you want?
You're a gambler, right?
A nickel here, a dime there, so what?
What does it mean to give knights odds in a chess game?
It's a handicap, like in golf. One player starts the game with one or both of his knights off the board.
Why?
Well, it's something a master player might offer in a match if you're playing a lesser player.
A lesser player?
Morning, Christine. What are you talking about?
He offered me knight's odds. He's toying with me, Mary Beth.
Knight's odds? Who?
Albert Grand. Do you know what he did? He rented a room in the public library and he hired a string quartet and then he lured me there.
When?
Last night.
Last night?
Oh, it's all very civilized, Mary Beth. Albert Grand is nothing if not civilized. That he had champagne and he had caviar and he had Beethoven. And then he did it all just to tempt me to give me knight's odds.
Christine, let me understand this now. You met Albert Grand last night in the New York City Public Library?
Right. And I've been up all night reading that damn book of his again. know there's something in there. He let something drop about chapter 11. I was sure I could find it. Night's odds! Me!
Christine, Christine, you're not making much sense here. Now I want you to sit down and take a deep breath.
I don't need to breathe.
In and out. Slow. Okay. Start again.
Chapter 11 talks about the best capers are like magic tricks, where the eye is sent over here when the real trick's happening over there. Or more likely, the trick's already happened before you even have a chance to know where to look.
You mean the rabbit's already in the hat?
Right.
I love magic tricks. You know, Harve had an uncle who used to do magic tricks. He'd make eggs come out of his mouth and he'd find quarters in your ears. It was great.
Well, it wasn't Doug Henning. Mary Beth.
What?
You just gave me an idea.
You did?
Come on. Come on!
Coming.
Lieutenant.
Oh, good morning, Petrie. I want to tell you, these gizmos are really something. A minute and 40 seconds and you get hot waffles and sausages.
Claudia's parents gave us one last Christmas. Makes things a lot easier with Warren. Lieutenant, I'm worried about his Becky.
His Becky? What for? Isn't he down in the Bahamas with the stripper? What's her name?
Bon Bon. Well, that's what he told everyone. But the thing is, she showed up here yesterday looking for her.
Oh, yeah, you think maybe he's got a little something new going?
I don't know, sir.
Well, anyway, Petrie, his personal life's his own business, right?
Yes, sir. I don't think he's in the Bahamas, Lieutenant. I think he's in the hospital.
Hospital?
I found this in his inbox.
Authorization for medical insurance payment for hospitalization. He didn't say something to you about a medical problem, did he?
Tried calling his apartment. I called his mother. Of course, I didn't want to say anything to worry her.
Hospital? But why would he make up a story like that about the Bahamas?
I have no idea, sir.
Do you know which hospital?
Not yet, but I'd like to run a check.
Yeah, well, I guess you better do that. Let me know what you find out, will you?
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Wait, please.
Well, that just one moment. Thank you.
Please, that is really quite sensitive.
Yes, I'm sure it is. I'm sure it is.
What is she doing? I wish you would not fiddle with
it. Mr. Harmon, just give us a second to work here, all right? Hello.
What is that?
That's an electronic eavesdropping device. It's a bug, sir.
My God. Shipment.
What shipment?
I discussed the arrangements for the couriers of the next shipment of raw diamonds from South Africa on that phone. It's too late to change them. The shipment is due in today.
Well, how much?
6.5 million. But they are raw diamonds, you see.
Well, see what, sir?
Finished gems have identifying traits, flaws, characteristics like fingerprints, but rough diamonds. That is why the secrecy, the couriers, totally untraceable.
Yeah, when is the shipping due today?
4:30.
Where?
Kennedy, gate 36, Trans-Allied Airline.
Thank let's you. Go. Let's go. Try not to worry, sir. First time Miss Chess came, I go one step ahead. And this time, I'm gonna get him.
Wait a minute, you're talking about a $6.5 million gamble here?
But, Lieutenant, I know I can nail him. I know I can this time. He as much as said so.
Grand told you? What?
Well, he said that he wanted to give me something that I could not prove had been stolen. Like, uncut diamonds.
That's it. It's a hell of a chance that you want to take here, Cagney.
I know, Lieutenant. That's why I was hoping maybe you would call Deputy Inspector Nelman and he could talk to the Vandeboer people and then they'd go along with it.
If we could have Leibowitz and Cross to go with us, you know, in case we have to front tail him, sir.
Lacey, would you mind? I want to talk to Cagney for a moment, please.
Certainly, sir.
You got your head screwed on, right?
I have very strong feelings about this one, Lieutenant.
Do you remember what he did last time?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Well, I don't want to see that happening to you again.
But I lost my cool then. It's different now.
Different, huh?
How do you know you're not playing right into this man's hands? He is the best in the world, Cagney. He's a master.
I know that, but this time he's given me a leg up. Now, I don't know why he has, but I know I'm going to nail him. And I'm asking you to give me a shot at it.
The room you'll be in is behind that two-way mirror over there. You can use walkie-talkies in there. It's been done before.
What's the signal?
Whoever gets the coil will take off his uniform cap, inspect the flash, and then put it back on.
Flash?
The insignia.
Oh, I got you.
Right this way. Flight's on its final approach.
Thank you.
Room 1409? Thank you. Would you connect me, please? Victor? Boy. Victor? Victor. Victor, don't try disguising your voice. I know it's you. Yes. Victor, what are you doing in the hospital? Yeah, Victor. Yes, I do want to know. Listen to me. I have just spent hours trying to track you down, Victor. Yes, I did. Hang on one second. Sergeant? The insurance. Yeah, the insurance friend. Uh-huh. Look, Bon Bon was in here yesterday. Yeah, I told her you were undercover. Well, you'll think of something. Victor, would you please tell me why you're in the hospital? Well, no, I'm not going to laugh, Victor. Victor, I won't laugh. I promise. Oh, you're kidding. Well, Victor, why did you have to go through this whole charade just because of a simple operation? Oh, no. That's nonsense. Victor, real men do have hemorrhoids.
Leave a bit. In position?
10-4.
Your attention, please. Interworld Airways, flight number 126 from San Francisco is now arriving at gate number 13.
There he is.
Attention, please.
Okay, we have a courier. He's a male Caucasian, tall, maybe 6'4". He's got a beard and glasses, gray coat, and he's got a brown flight bag. You got him?
Got him.
Dr. Bert Finley, pick up a white courtesy telephone. Dr.
Wait a
Bert Finley.
Two couriers?
White courtesy telephone.
So we're following both. Okay, we have a second courier. You stay on the tall guy. We got a young woman in a yellow slicker gray scarf.
10-4.
Oh, no. Mm-mm. Mary Beth, you follow the fat one. You have Leibowitz follow the girl and Cross to take the tall guy. What about you? Mary Beth, I just realized what he was talking about in Chapter 11 all that time, about the rabbit being in the hat already. It's exactly what you said. What? About the trick having been over before it even began. Christine! Just follow him. Cross, you stay with the tall guy. Leibowitz, you take the girl. I'm on a fat man with a fur hat. We got three of them.
I should never have taken my nights off the board for you, my dear.
Why, Albert? Why all those calling cards and the night's odds? Why this whole game?
I decided to have some fun. And what could be more fun than matching wits with the best detective I've ever known? It's an old man's foolish conceit. Thank you.
You used the security telephone to change the flight that the diamonds came in on, didn't you?
My Afrikaans is a trifle rusty, but it suffices.
The doctor that you visited, we were told that he was just a general internist.
Oh, he is. But he's also one of the finest thoracic men in the country. It's a delaying action at best.
So you knew all along?
The knowledge that I would never live long enough to face jail gave me a certain freedom.
The valises?
It's a gesture. The last move of the king before checkmate. I haven't even got enough strength to get dressed. Say something to you, which I've never said to any police officer on five continents. I confess.
This is ridiculous. You're a thief.
Think of me as an artist, if you can. That I've known you. I suppose you won't keep these diamonds now that I've confessed. So? Please. To remember me by. Please.
It's beautiful, Albert.
I bought it.
You bought it?